Happy Halloween. We've had two exhibition games, a scrimmage and exhibition, two contests against Iowa State and Mississippi State. You know, it's great going against Power Five because you get a true look at, you know, who can do what, who's where. I think we've competed pretty well. When you look at, you know, if you believe in Ken Pom and computer numbers, you've got, you know, Iowa State is a top 35 team and Mississippi State is a top 60, and we're right around 100 to 110. So to be able to go out and do well, I think is promising, but yet there's a lot of work to be done. As I look at our team specifically, you know, our defense has got to get better. I think that we've got to get the rust off some of those guys that have been injured, like Isaac Copeland, Anton Gill, Jordan Chimunga, who sat out 5 weeks in preseason. They're not up to par in my book. And some of those younger guys just need to take the next step and figure things out. You know, Thomas Allen was much better yesterday than he had been previously. Isaiah Roby does so many different things. I hold him to such a high exacting standard. It's probably not fair, but I thought he did some good things yesterday too. And of course, you know, the guys that have really rose to the occasion, the three guys have been, you know, Jack McVeigh looks more comfortable shooting the ball and has shot it really well. James Palmer's done some really good things. And quite frankly, highly, highly productive, and his coach doesn't play him that much. I might have to look at his minutes, but James just does enough to, you know, keep me on edge too. That's what I love about him. And of course, Glenn Watson is I think, an all-league type guard. So I like the direction we're going, and got a lot of work left to do. We got a lot of work left to do, and in a short time, you know. So here we go. Any questions?
Two of the biggest emphases you had this offseason were improved three-point shooting, improved three-point defense, two scrimmage exhibitions in. How do you think that those?
Well, we've shot it better. Next question.
Who's your three-point defensive coach?
Well, it's been Jim Molinari, and no, it's not. You know, like yesterday, same thing. You know, Solomon Young comes out for Iowa State, their center with 12 feet range, and makes two threes like it's just nothing. And Tanner Borhardt's looking at him, and he's looking at me, and I'm like, get on him! You know what I mean? Just like, yeah, we told you he had 12 foot, you know, range, but you know, like their center hit two threes on us right away. And you know, it's just stuff like that. But we'll get better. There's no doubt about it. We'll get better.
You've already been thinking about your team as maybe an already known in this first year?
Yesterday was more, you know, we built a big lead against Mississippi State, as you guys saw, and then kind of let them back into it. Well, more than kind of. And then yesterday, we had a lead, 10-point at halftime. They came back, took the lead, and then we charged through. And I like the versatility of the team. We can play really small. Yesterday, we had a lineup. Isaiah Roby at the five, technically Evan Taylor at the four, Palmer at the three, and then two guards with Glenn and Thomas Allen, and that group made a run to lengthen out our lead. And I wouldn't expect I played that group until I was mad enough just to put them in. And we've never practiced it or anything, but I think that tells you a little bit about the versatility. Evan had to kind of do a check on a few plays. Like, wait, okay, I got it, you know? And that's always a mark, too, of a, you know, Evan is a guy that I haven't talked much about, but he's got juice, athletic ability, he's got quickness, he's got a motor, he really plays hard defensively. He's been a rock for us. His standard of work in practice is outstanding. You can tell his dad was a player at Xavier, and has you know, raised him in a manner of this is what a winning culture looks like, and he's really been good for us.
Nana hasn't played in either of those.
Yeah, we're already playing 10 or 11, and it's just hard to get, you know, a 12th guy in there. Nana is a guy that's got loads of talent, but you know, just in terms of this niche right now, probably has further to go than the rest of the guys. just in terms of team defense, acclimations, ball handling, he can shoot it, and he's as athletic as anybody. It's just a matter of time for him.
I know you generally wait until the season gets closer.
We're going to meet as a staff actually after this and talk about, okay, do we redshirt anybody? Do we not redshirt anybody? And who's a candidate for that? Of course, those two young freshmen, being Thor and Nana, would be guys you'd discuss it with. And sometimes if you think that a redshirt is going to be, they're going to get a lot out of the redshirt, you know, some guys need that idea they're going to play. And some guys don't do so well in the redshirting. And so I think we just have to talk to them real honestly, too, about, you know, where their mind is and what their expectations are.
So Palmer shooting 11 free throws, is that an important stat?
He gets fouled a lot in practice. You know, we stat chart every practice, and James is a guy that does, his foul rate, free throw rate's way up there. And that's good because we've needed that type of player. And you know, Glenn is not that type of guard. And James played, you know, like I say, 1, 2, and 3 fours yesterday. And so I just, when I look at him, he's a guy that when he's on the attack, he's good. And he didn't end the game. He missed, I think, his last two or three shots, two for sure. But, you know, he's a guy I think that's just going to get better and better as he, you know, he's jumping into a bigger role. So that's an adjustment for him mentally, conditioning. You know, in Miami, he was, an accent, you know, so to speak. And here I need him to be more than that.
How does he get most of his points? Is he?
Well, he gets, you know, he's really good transition. He can come off a screen and shoot. He can spot shoot, you know, finding the creases off somebody else's penetration. And then he can put the ball on the floor and just, you know, like all those other guys I've had, just drive it through a nail hole. And you need that too. You know, he takes contact pretty well too and finishes. He had a couple, I think he had an N1 yesterday and against Mississippi State where he took contact, maybe even in his left hand finishes. He's really built his core stronger that way. And he used to kind of be this, herky-jerky, kind of smooth guy that wanted to get a shot off and a little more direct now to the rim.
So I know you're going off with just two exhibition games in practice, but do you feel like your perimeter shooting is going to be significantly better this year?
It has to be. Yeah, we just have to shoot the ball better if we're going to be in this league, with the amount of talent in this league and the depth, and with our schedule the way it is, we have to be able to make threes, you know.
With you guys playing really well in the scrimmages, but a lot of teaching moments, obviously, do you think those probably went as well as they could have as far as preseason scrimmages go?
Well, here's why they went well, because we screwed up a lot. And so there's a lot to be taught on – you name it, discipline, whether it be defensively or ball handling or shot selection, whether it be just team defense, little errors that cost us. Twice we had guys just overhelp unnecessarily that cost us threes. And if they can learn to do, like you'll see Anton Gill and Evan Taylor will stay with their men and not allow the shot, but you'll see Thomas Allen and Isaiah Roby over help. You know, it's just a lack of experience and discipline. So the quicker we can ratchet that up with those guys, I think the better off we'll be. You're right. It went well because there's a lot of teaching to be done. But yeah, we came out with two good outcomes. And you want to feel positive about that because every team, I don't care who you are, there are some programs that just have culture wins. You know, I mean, that every year you know what you're getting. And we just have had too much turnover, quite frankly, in the last 2 years, that this team's got to figure out how to win so now they can set the tone for the rest of us. And we know that. I mean, it's just the way it is.
One more question, Coach.
You mentioned the defense being needed to improve, but at the same time, you're scoring a lot of points. How much of that is finding the balance between pushing the tempo offensively, trying to create more offense, but also playing the level of defense?
Yeah, I think that your main absolutes, like guard, get back, guard the ball, contest shot, those are the ones that you have to fight them on. And you're at a high level too. You know, there were some plays that they made yesterday where you understand why they're the 34 team in all the computer rankings, because they can make plays. Yeah. You know? And so I think you just have to stay with the fundamentals, fight them on that, and hope that we can continue to progress offensively.
Thank you.